X365. So in the most of the projects, we have the scenarios like we have to do the integration with the other systems. So in that scenario, we may need to develop the custom web APIs to integrate, to communicate with the other systems. Or in other case, they will give the, their custom web APIs. We may need to integrate with our CRM. So first in this video, I'm taking a one scenario. So this scenario here I'm taking to exposing the list of the opportunities data to the downstream applications. In that scenario, how we can write the web API. So that we will discuss it now. So before going to that, I just want to highlight it. What is a web API? So web API is an application programming interface. So that is used to enable the communication or interaction with the software components with each other. And it is easier to build the HTTP service that reaches the a broad range of clients, including the browsers and mobile devices, and using the ASP.NET and web API can enable to communicate by different devices from the same database. And what is the benefits we'll get it? So it is used to access the service data in the web application as well as many mobile apps and other external devices. And it is used to create a RESTful web services, and REST stands for representational state transfer, which is an architectural style for the networked hypermedia applications. And it is primarily used to build the web services that are lightweighted, maintainable and scalable and support limited bandwidth. And it is used to create a simple web service. It supports the XML or JSON and other data formats. So with basically with the web API, so we will get the HTTP methods. So the following methods are the commonly used for REST-based architecture. We have the method GET. So GET provides the read-only access to the data. So wherever you want to expose our data, so then we will use the GET method. And PUT method we used for if you want to create a record by using the web API, that web API method type we can keep it as a PUT. And delete, we will use to delete the record through the web API, we will use the delete. And post, if you want to use this, you want to update the existing data in the through web API. Project, new project. We can go to the C sharp. Under C sharp, we can select the web, and we can select the ASP.NET web application. And here we can queue the our project name. So I'm taking a sample. Web API. I'm taking the project name as sample web API. I'm giving a sample custom web API. This is the name I'm giving. And once you click on OK, it will ask you which type of the template you want to use it. We need to select the Azure API app. So once you click on OK, it will create the project for us. So once the project is created for us, so you can go to the solution explorer. Here you can see this all projects it will be created in MEC. So since it's a custom web API, so it will use the framework for the MEC. We have the controller and we have the model here. And here by default we will get the value controller here with the default method. So we can create our own controller here. Right click on the controller, add it, and we can take a new controller here. And this controller, as of now, I'm taking that API empty controller. Click on that. Here we can give that our controller name, opportunity. You can click on add. So once the controller is added, and here in the controller class, we need, it will be inherited API controller. It's an abstract class in the MEC framework. It will inherit that abstract classes. So, and this abstract class is part of the using the system.web.http, that namespace. So once this control is created, then second step, we need to create a model. Okay, so we need to create a model here. So here in the model, right click, add a class. In that model, so this class name, we need to take it as a opportunity. That model name. So in this model, we need to declare that properties. Whatever the fields from the opportunity entity, you want to expose it into the web API. For simple example, I am exposing that name field. So I'm creating a property, one property here that in that model. So here the data type I'm taking as a string, string name, and model I'm declaring as a public. And here we can keep it as a get. And set, I'm declaring this is a property, I declared it here. Okay, so once we can save this one. Okay, this is a property, we have it. So if you want n number of the properties, so what are the fields you want to expose it? Those are all the properties for all the fields. You need to define the property here, and we can. Once we have created that model, now we need to add that CRM DLLs. So to add that CRM DLLs, we need to go to the Azure in the NuGet. In the NuGet, we can take it this command and we can add it to the our project. So here we can right click on the project, manage the NuGet packages. Sorry, in the manage so we can go to the tools and manage package console. So we can enter these details. So this all the DLLs which will be added to the our project now, all the CRM DLLs. Now once it is added, that CRM DLLs, we can go back to the controller. Here that controller class. So here first we need to define that method. So like a post or get methods, we need to define it here. Before that, we need to add it. That CRM SDK DLL, we need to add to the class. So Microsoft dot XRM dot SDK. And we need to add the model also to this class using. So sample web API, this is the namespace dot models,
we need to add it here. So then only this, whatever the model class we have created, that class we can able to access it here. So here one web method I'm creating. So public I want to return it as a object type. So we are taking the object model as a return type. So we can take it as a get. So get is for return the value. So I'm taking the get method in the control. So here we need to create a CRM connection string. So we need to create an IR ignition service. So for that, what are the standard code lines of code we will use it, that we can use it here. So for that, for creating an IR ignition service, so we already have some predefined methods. So I'm just copying this code. And I will be explaining. So here, so the first thing we have declared that list here. So list opportunity, that object list we have declared. So in the get method, so I'm reading that username password from the web.config. So here, which is we want to connect to the CRM. Okay, so this one we are using it, system.config is that DLL is required. So with that, we are using that username and password here. And here that query expression, we need to add the xrm.sdk.query. So here, once this service is created, so this is the methods, a service creation method we have. So that's a standard method we have. That CRM URL we are reading and we are with that we are creating this IR ignition service, and that service will be returned to us. Okay, so once the service is created, so here the CRM IR ignition service is available. I'm doing the query expression for the opportunity entity. I'm just taking all the columns here, column set. I'm taking all the columns. I didn't keep the any filter condition. If you want, you can extend that this filter conditions and thing. And what we are doing here, so what are the result we got it? We are looping these details here. Okay, we are looping the record by record, and that we have taken an object. We have initiated that object model class. So whatever the name field we have, that name, if it is not equal to null, then I'm setting that I'm reading from the that opportunity record, that name value, and we are setting to that. And finally, I'm setting into the object in that list. I'm adding that. Once that final list for all the records is completed, I'm returning it here. So this is a simple custom WebAPI. We have done that coding. So to test it, so we need to configure that app.config in that web.config. In the app settings, we need to add that keys here. So that keys, I'm just adding it. So here, whatever the name you have mentioned in the key name, this is a key. this same name you should use in your code in the controller. So here I'm using the same name. So now once we build, so once you build it, it should build succeeded. So here to test this web APIs, so we have a Swagger UI. So under app settings here, app underscore start folder, we have a Swagger config. So here in that Swagger config, we need to uncomment the some lines here in the below. So here you can see this star, this enable that Swagger UI. We need to uncomment it. Then we can save. When you run here, it will run the application. So here we have to enter Swagger to test that our web appli- web API. So this Swagger UI, it will open. So here we can go to the list of operations. So under this opportunity control, we have this get method. Once you click on that, if you click on it, try it out, it will trigger that method and we can get that response here. So now we can see here. So this is a API response name in a JSON format. It is written that. Okay. As of now, we are returning as a name only. So we can extend it as a needed. Whatever the fields are you wanted to pass it additionally, we can that you can extend it by adding that fields in the model, and we can read it and we can assign the values to that particular field. So like this, we can able to develop the web APIs, custom web APIs for Dynamics 365. So in our next session, I can explain how we can deploy this web API, whatever the sample web API we have developed it, how we can deploy into the Azure. That I can explain in our next sessions. Thank you so much for watching this video.